Hello, Windows Universe. In this video, we will talk about what MSConfig, or System Configuration Utility, is. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. So, what is MSConfig in Windows 10? MSConfig, or System Configuration Utility, helps users troubleshoot Windows startup issues. It allows the management of startup selection, safe boot, enable or disable Windows services. You can find and launch system tools like Performance Monitor, Resource Monitor, and more. The System Configuration Utility is more of a diagnostics tool and offers some great controls for configuring the startup of the system. To open MSConfig, you need to open a run prompt, which is Windows and the R key, and type in MSConfig and click OK. It will launch the System Configuration Utility, and it has the General tab, which allows you to boot Windows in diagnostic or selective mode when necessary. The boot can manage everything related to the Windows boot, including safe mode. Services: enable or disable Windows or other services. Startup: the startup section is now managed via the Task Manager. Tools: you can launch popular system services from here. In the General tab, there are three types of startup selection: normal, diagnostic, and selective. Normal: it boots the system without any diagnostic services. If you're trying to diagnose a problem, select one of the other two options. And when the issue is resolved, go back to normal. In diagnostic, this will make sure Windows boots with essential services and drivers, enough to start the computer. It helps to make sure to find out notorious third-party services and software that could be causing a problem. And selective: use this selection to speed up computer startup. The user can choose to disable services and programs which need to not start with Windows. The selective startup mode not only allows to start the system with essential services and drivers like diagnostic, but it also allows to correctly configure the use of additional services in startup applications. So that means that the user can slowly determine what is causing the problem in the boot process. The user can go through and turn on items one at a time from the service or startup tabs and see how the system reacts on reboot. In the boot options, under safe boot, you have minimum, which boots the Windows GUI but only running critical services. Network functions are also disabled. If you find the system is working at this level, then try turning on services to see if they cause any further issues. Alternative shell: use this option to boot a command prompt. It will keep the critical services running, but networking and the GUI are disabled. Active Directory repair: it boots the Windows GUI running critical services in Active Directory. Safe boot in the network: you use this boot to boot to Windows GUI running critical services and networking. If the problem is not the networking services, then having the network turned on for the system will help. It will allow access to resources needed on the network or the internet for diagnosis. In the Services tab, if any of the Windows services is causing an issue, then this selection will allow you to deselect, and it helps you figure. It lists all of the services which start with the boot. You can uncheck and check to prevent any service from starting up the next time the system is booted. When choosing to deselect services, the startup mode will change the selective startup to make sure not to disable any of the Windows system services. And you just check the box to select hide services in Windows. Be careful when deciding to disable a service because this might cause other problems while attempting to search for the one causing the original problem. Some services are compulsory for the system to operate correctly. Other services, if disabled, may throw off the diagnostic approach because it may be affecting other aspects of your operating system. In the newer versions of Windows 10, the section to manage startup items is now available with the Task Manager. And you can choose to enable or disable applications to start with Windows here. Use it to make certain applications that register themselves to start with Windows can be removed. It can improve overall boot timing. The Tools tab provides a list of diagnostic and informational tools and shows the location of these tools and a description of what they do. In this tab, the user can launch any system tool or note the location or the name of the tool itself. Now, what's great about this is that it's a central location to all sorts of tools and even a few pre-configured command line options. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.